So I just got ready as I showed you guys, but today I wanted to do a video with Dixon and just kind of like a day in my life with him, like what we normally do. Honestly, there's not much to do because of the COVID restrictions in my city and because I'm getting a lot of comments that you guys want him back in my videos, which sometimes I put like snippets of him and stuff. So I'm going to take you guys along with me. Also, I didn't really get to show you guys how I did my hair because I already had it up. For those of you who are going to ask how I did my hair, I used this Revlon, what is it called? It's like one of those blow dryer brushes. All right, so I'm just about to head out, but I kind of want to show you guys my foundation today because I use the Morphe, what is it called? They sent me a package of their Soft Focus foundation that they recently dropped, and I tried it out today. It was also not like a very heavy coverage. It's kind of more towards the medium coverage, so yeah, I like it. I also wanted to show you guys what I got in the mail, so I'm gonna do a little bit of a try on haul. So I got a package from ThredUp and they have such cute packaging with polka dots all around it. So if you guys didn't know what ThredUp is, it's basically your online thrift store. They have a bunch of your favorite brands, probably such as like Alexander Wang, Helmut Long, Free People, and many more that you can shop online for up to 90% off their retail price, their estimated retail price. Also, they have over 40k brands with new arrivals every single day, so there's a lot to shop for. I love online shopping, so the fact that I can online thrift as well is probably the best thing for me because not a lot of my thrift trips are very successful because I really am just probably very lazy to go through the racks and racks of clothes, and so now I'm going to show you guys everything that I got from ThredUp. Stay tuned for a special promo that you guys can use, but I'm going to start off with probably my favorite piece that I got, and it is these pair of boots, which it's kind of like a snakeskin print. I think that's a snakeskin, right? It gives me very Y2K vibes. I got this from their assorted brand section, and this one retailed for $60, and I got it for $39.99. And then I also got this really cute tote bag in this really nice gray color. It also has that type of like printing all over it. This one was actually from Topshop. This one retailed for about $89 and I got it for $24.99. I also got this really cute maxi dress from Alexander Wang in black. It's a very kind of, you know, your typical kind of maxi dress, but it's really nice to wear for vacation. It's a very thin fabric too, which makes it perfect to wear for the summertime, but this one retailed for $190 and I got it for $41.99. This next piece I got is actually from an unknown source. I don't know. I think it's like unbranded, but it is a really cute little top to wear for the summertime. Honestly, I'm just imagining myself at a beach because I miss it. I miss vacation, and so I'm literally shopping for vacation clothes right now. I don't know why. So it is this really cute khaki green tie top. This one retailed for $48 and I got it for $14.99. Ooh, I also got this really cute vest and it has a fur lining on the front. So very Y2K again. This is from the brand Nick and Zoe. So this one retailed for about $268 and I got it for $48.99. I got a couple of black tops, but the first one is from Alexander Wang, which is from his Tea by Alexander Wang line. It is basically this simple black tee, very lightweight as well and very thin fabric. Again, for the summertime. This one retailed for $95 and I got it for $24.99. This other black top that I got is from this brand called Allison Joy, and it is a kind of low scoop top. Obviously, you have to wear something underneath, probably like a bralette or whatever. This one I got for $8.99, but it retailed for $54. Next one I got from Helmut Long, which is this really cute white vest that I think will be perfect for, you know, as a cover up for your bikini. But yeah, it's a simple little pullover that I got. This retailed for $3.95 and I got it for $62.99. So the last one that I have here is from Alexander Wang, and it is this top that I actually thought was like leather, but it looks like leather from afar. It's more of like a dressy top as well, so perfect to dress up. This one retailed for $450 and I got it for $199.99. So that is everything that I got from ThredUp. If you guys want to shop, make sure to use my link down below and use my code Koleen to get an extra 30% off your first order. So I am gonna go ahead and go change. So today's outfit looks like this. Luna at the back going crazy. You guys, my hair with like my new hair color looks so good. I don't know if you guys can see it in this lighting, but maybe like under the sun you'll see it a lot better. So for my outfit, it's kind of like the same as the other outfit that I showed you guys, obviously like with the top, the pants, and the shoes. This is basically the whole outfit. I wanted to layer because I think it's kind of cold outside. I also got my nails done, which I forgot to show you guys, but it looks so cute. Also got a couple of more rings on this side. You guys, we waited in line for so long, for an hour.
30 minutes.
Dude, Dixon is literally freezing. But we're here for like the wagyu steak, and we're probably gonna like grab a couple more things, and we'll see what they have. So what do we have?
First, we have this color palette. Let's see if
it's kind of more of the stone gray. I don't think it really matches the jacket though.
Yeah, but
I think the green, this will work better because it maybe like that would be perfect. Like this color with the jacket would be perfect because.
Let's try it on.
Okay. Well, you can't try it on.
There's no trying.
No, because of COVID. Sorry.
Girl.
It does relate to you more than you think.
Nope. I hate you.
You know the song?
What the hell am I knowing the song? Oh, but am I playing her songs?
No. You know the song? You really?
Yeah, this was my song.
Sure.
Baby, I know that you like me. You're my future wife. Sounds of what? Tell them. You could be my bun. I can be your client.
So. Why are you crying?
What's your favorite brand?
No, you can't.
What's your favorite brand?
Wait,
what's your favorite brand?
You're so annoying. Why are you capping? Why
are
you capping?
Pepe.
No, I said a question.
What's your favorite brand?
I'm not about to make you look like you're not
looking.
I'm crying. I'm crying. I'm freaking dead. You need to know Destiny's Child. Are you serious? Yo.
You can play it.
Yo.
I wasn't popping with this.
Nah.
I wasn't popping with this. I was on my Lil Wayne, Drake, Nicki Minaj. Who else?
I don't even know the lyrics.
Good. See, you don't know the song.
Hey. I just love the music.
Oh, yeah.
I never had a vibe. Show me all the things that you can show me. And especially when you call me, we won't always be together.
Swinging in the backyard, pull up in your fast car, whistling my name. Open up a beer and you say get over here and play a video game. I'm in his favorite sundress, watching me get undressed, take a party downtown. I see you the bestest, leaning for a big kiss, put his favorite perfume on. Go play your video game. It's you, it's all for you. Everything I do, tell you all the time. Heaven is a place on earth with you. Tell me all the things you want to do. I heard that you like the bad girls, honey.
Masks,
sir? So the first question that I'm thinking of as we answer.
I asked you guys to send me questions on Instagram stories for us to answer, just so we have more content. This video will be like 5 minutes long if we just like...
No, it wouldn't. I'm so interested. It wasn't that funny.
But we're gonna start off with... Oh, yeah. Okay, so we're gonna start off with the most... oh my god, I can't talk.
Can I see your questions?
Wait, so I'm gonna start off. wait, what was I gonna say? What the? Two of them. Dixon. And...
It's story time.
Why are you so annoying? Open your eyes.
Then I'll come in.
So, how did we meet? Long story short.
Okay, long story short.
We met at school.
Yeah, we met at school. Uni. I chased her.
Fair enough.
No, I didn't chase her.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
I walked up to you and I was like, what did you
Okay,
I had to plan to know where she was going to be because it's a small school. No, is it small?
Big school.
It's a big school. Sorry, why did I say small? It's a big school. So, like, anybody finna just run into somebody except it's intentional or, like, you know, like, what it is. Like, if not, you just leave it to chance.
And
leave anything to chance in this life. You gotta do what you gotta do. So, I was like, you know what to do? I'm gonna come out at that time, go there. She can't miss me. She was walking fast as hell, too. I was like, no, no, this is destiny. You gotta promote this stuff.
When you force your own destiny,
you gotta make your own destiny.
I was literally sprinting, bro. Like,
she wasn't sprinting. She can't even sprint, bro. Her sprint is a walk. But, like, she was like walking fast, and I was just like, yo. I was very like straight to the point. I don't know how to make small talk.
How long have you been together?
Technically,
4 years.
Technically, yeah.
Four. What do you mean
technically? Four times two, eight. Okay, four years, one.
Oh, that's it for me, so good. Do you feel any big culture difference?
Culture difference? There's always culture difference. You come from
obviously we're different from two different cultures.
Even if you're just like friends with somebody that's like from a different culture, there's always big like a shift. And it's just a matter of like handling them the right way, you know what I mean? Communicating them. You feel me?
Yeah.
Because like everyone has a different perspective on life. Even if you come from the same place, the same country, the same tribe, every family has a different perspective on life.
Mm-hmm.
So there always is just how much you handle them.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow. Can we speaker?
Professor.
Who said I love you first?
I don't know the
answer to that question.
No.
So obviously it was him. I mean, don't how can you story. Not love me?
I don't know what
you
happened.
Said, but
she got me mad.
She's mad.
Just mad. Don't ask no stupid question.
One thing you dislike about one another.
How many?
Not a lot, to be honest.
What do you dislike? She doesn't listen. She's stubborn. Sometimes. That's it.
Sometimes.
That's the most annoying.
But no, but like the only thing that really annoys you about me is when I don't bring like a luggage.
Yo, fam, she doesn't travel with a hand luggage. Do you know how many times she travels and gets to her destination and then her like her
thing is lost.
Her baggage isn't lost or like it's delayed for like 2 days and she's telling me, I don't have anything to wear. I can't really, like, duh, I told you the night before, take a hand luggage.
The number one thing that I dislike about him is that he doesn't take care of himself. Like, health, how he eats, how he sleeps. Like, he doesn't know the balance between a healthy lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? He would, like, wake up one day, eat cereal, like, 2 p.m., and then never eat again after that. Or he would eat, or he would drink before, like, he would drink Coke and, like, eat chips for lunch. I'm like... Biggest thing you've learned from your relationship? Not that I've learned, but I feel like because of the relationship, because of the relationship that we have, you kind of brought me closer to God.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah,
that's like the biggest thing for me.
It's an emphasis on putting God first in all things. Like, no, like,
it changes your life literally.
Yeah, like relationships don't matter. Like, you put God first before anybody, like before your parents, before your loved ones, like. God first, then them.
Does us being religious help solidify the relationship?
I think, yeah. Mm-hmm. With any relationship, with any like friendship, if you put God first,
it's
you're
like,
less likely to make mistakes.
Yeah.
You're less likely to like fall into the wrong things and like do the wrong things. Because you know your priorities, you know your goals, you know where you want to be.
No, no, what also helps solidify us is we share the same values, you know? We share the same kind of religious aspect as putting God first, and we also have the same values and morals that we share. And I feel like that's what really like strengthens a relationship, because if you take those out, I feel like you don't have a solid relationship.
I think also it helps you understand that, you know, God owns the future, you know, and like wherever
nothing
you're going,
is set on stone.
Nothing is set in stone. Like, nothing is set in stone. So you commit everything.
We're not set on stone. You know, we're not. Yeah. We don't know if we're gonna end up together, like end up getting married and stuff like that. That's why we don't plan for that, because anything can happen, and you know, God can put someone in your life just to learn from them and grow with them.
The future is God's to know, and like, not, you don't know who you're supposed to be with till it's time. Mm-hmm. And like, you pray about that God shows you that person that you're supposed to spend the rest of your life with, because the last thing you want to do is make a mistake, you know, like,
yeah,
be with the wrong person and be sad as hell,
and like, be sad like when you're married. That. What are your plans now that you graduated?
She's gonna dip, she's, God willing, move somewhere.
Mm-hmm. I just don't want to stay in Calgary.
Nobody's finished staying in Calgary. This is like, I feel like this stage, this time period is end,
crucial.
The end for Calgary.
Mm-hmm.
And just about like next steps and going back home, experiences.
Traveling, just like experiencing life in a whole different perspective, because honestly, it's gonna be hard starting over with, you know, not a lot of your friends with you, because like, I've known Calgary to be like my safe and home space. I feel comfortable here.
You can't be comfortable.
In order for me to grow, like, I need to be uncomfortable and like put myself in situations where I can kind of grow. Why are his eyebrows always on fleek?
Because she be tweezing them. Taking care.
I do with my eyebrows, baby. Do you guys think you can survive long distance? We can try it, but I haven't been before, and he hasn't been either. I mean, this is like, we're each other's first, so it's kind of hard to say if we'll survive that, but we can try.
Yeah.
We'll see how it goes.
My priority is also that we always stay like friends and connected and like continue to help each other grow.
Mm-hmm.
Like, relationship is cool, but like we said before, like,
I feel like if anything, we're more of like, our friendship is stronger than our romantic relationship.
I really wanted to like solidify like a good friendship more than anything else,
because it's what makes like a romantic relationship, I feel like, strong.
Yeah.
But what's your favorite thing about each other's personality?
You're very caring. Like she finna cry for you, and like she's very compassionate.
Compassionate,
like she.
I think
like for
anyone, honestly, like
especially
that's
her,
going
like
it.
Her dog too, like she's compassionate for. Like, I'm like, how do you have mad emotions for a dog?
Everyone can. What do you mean?
No, but like I'm not judging you. I'm just saying. Like, so like she's mad compassionate about like the people she cares about, which is a lovely trait.
Thanks. So you take out the comb.
passionate.
And eerily with passionate. Yeah. He's very passionate about and like very strong-willed about what he wants to go for. And it inspires me, honestly, because I feel like I'm like kind of
you're more chill.
The opposite. Something doesn't go my way, for example, taking content, and I'm really like a perfectionist about. If I'm like taking content, it doesn't go my way, I literally instantly collapse.
You don't know how many times we go take a pic, and like I have to spend like 30 minutes telling her, let's just try, let's just see if it works.
Mm-hmm.
But like if the hair isn't right, the light is just slightly off, she's done for the day, and it's like.
That's the better style. You better answer this right.
Me, duh. But dressing wise and stylistic wise, I'm not even at that point in life where like I dress up as much. Like I really just wear the same things because like all my focus and like my investments is towards my business. Like in the last like 3 years, I don't think I've spent $1, like over $100, even buying anything for myself to like just wear and like push your style of content. Mm-hmm. You know.
So what's the answer?
There's no answer. You have to wait and see.
No,
you have to wait and see.
No. So you're really gonna discredit me like that?
I'm not discredit. You have a fabulous, wonderful style. Don't get it twisted. Pedal-like.
Wait and see. Are you guys the same age? Yes. I'm 20. Ooh.
23.
I was about to say 24. I was like, yeah, I'm 23.
Almost
23. But he's...
April 5th, April 23rd. 18
so we're only
days.
A couple.
15 days, I don't know.
Okay, yeah. What are your names for each other on your phone? This is kind of cute. Show them your name. Show them my name. What is it called?
Miss Moon.
Miss Moon. And then we both have like baby pictures of each other. Big belly. What does Miss Moon mean? Explain. Moon. Elaborate.
Just like your mommy. It's just like, you know. It was like actually, it's like a Wale thing where he made this song.
Yeah, I know.
The song is called Miss Moon.
But
I
what
really
was the connection?
It was just like, you know, like, for someone to be kind of like your moon, it's like it's kind of like a very solemn feeling. Like to say solemn, like, it's like a night. Ruin the vibe. But like it's like just like when you think of the moon, it's just calm.
But so I make you calm.
Anyways,
and safe.
Okay, you're pushing it at safe, but calm. Huh? You're pushing it at safe.
Yes, no, I meant like a safe space.
Oh,
to be vulnerable.
Okay. Vulnerable.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, I get what you mean.
Baby, I know what I do to you.
Anyways.
So, thanks for coming to our TED Talk.
You're welcome.
Yeah, we don't take pictures together.
Because
like
I don't take pictures. It's kind of, it's a me thing.
Dixon,
though.
Yeah.
I'm in the same outfit trying to work.
Yeah.
I don't be taking
And even like generally too, like just like selfies, random selfies together and stuff. Like, Dixon's not the type to really like do that and post. I'm the type to obviously always take pictures.
Like I post a picture once a year. Who I needed that, and they wanna see me with that. Where I needed that, I know I exaggerated things. Now I got it like that. Stop my napkin in my shirt, girl, I'm just smiling like that. You know good and well that you don't want a problem like that. You gon' make someone around me touch your body like that. Oh, don't do it. Hey, those my brothers, I ain't even gotta say it. That's just something they know. They know.
You look like Will Smith from The Pursuit.
I hate your bloody ass.
Show them your outfit. Kendra said he looks like Will Smith from where?
From The Pursuit of Happiness.
AKA, she just said I look like a scrub. That's what she just said. This disrespectful.
Yeah, we're both wearing like this vintage jacket. And then pants, shoes.
We cute or whatever.